Thank you. Please, Lady Chai, dry your eyes.
The thought of never seeing you again is more than my poor heart can bear.
Oh, it's you. As you can see, Alfano has broken the news. I don't know how to console her. She thinks we'll be lost without him.
Indeed, my friend. Nothing unsaid. Lady Chai, I have a confession to make. On the day we ousted Lord Vorthry, when I revealed the truth of his tyranny and your complicity in his crimes, I did so with great trepidation. Not out of fear that you wouldn't listen, but that you might never recover. There was a time when I too, in my hubris, believed myself worthy to lord it over others. And when the lie was laid bare, when I was forced to confront the cost, the lives lost, it all but destroyed me. To awaken from a naive dream to so harsh a reality, I would have understood had you all surrendered to despair. But you didn't surrender. Far from it. You picked yourselves up and rose to the challenge. You found a path forward and the strength to walk it, and to keep walking it, day after day. But what struck me is how much faster you found it than I did.
Really? It felt pretty slow to me. But rest assured, we'll make Yulmore into a nation anyone would be proud to call home. Eventually. You can still come and go as you please, I believe. When we have good tidings to report, I may trouble you to be their bearer. There may also be less than good tidings. In which event, I hope I can trouble you for your counsel.
I should be honored to provide it, Master Chai.
Oh, Alfano, I know you aren't one to sit still, but do remember to take your ease from time to time. And no matter where you are, remember that there are people here who are praying for your health and happiness. Our brave and gentle artist, you have our love, now and always.
And you mine. Please take care.